morning, friends. Professor Pratap Bhanu Mehta, our chief guest this morning, Dr. Bimal Patel, president of SEPT University, members of the governing board, deans of various faculties, faculty members, members of the administration, graduating students, parents, and guests. Welcome to the 9th convocation of SEPT University. It is a great pleasure to have amongst us Professor Pratap Bhanu Mehta as our chief guest today. He is a political scientist and scholar par excellence. Dr. Patel has already listed his many significant accomplishments. Professor, SEPT University is honored to have you with us today. There are exciting times for all of us, especially you. All of you are graduating at a time when the Indian GDP is ready to take off and touch the $10 trillion mark in the next 20 years. India's urban population, which stands at 31%, is also rising rapidly. This necessitates better planning of cities. To accommodate this rapid urbanization, the Government of India has allocated US$1.2 billion in the fiscal year 2014-15 to build 100 new smart cities and develop satellite towns around existing cities. A high power expert committee on investment estimates in urban infrastructure has estimated an investment of around 7 lakh crore rupees over the next 20 years for the development of these smart cities. By 2025, approximately 50 crore Indians will be living in urban cities. In the next 15 years, India will have 13 cities with a population of more than 4 million, which is more than most of the big cities in the world. It is needless to say that this provides tremendous opportunities to young architects, planners, technologists, designers, and landscape designers like all of you. The university seems to be transforming in many ways, undertaking new initiatives while keeping its core values squarely in focus. Dr. Patel has mentioned a number of new initiatives and reforms just a few minutes back. The impact of many of these is already becoming visible. This is no mean achievement. I commend him, the faculty and staff, for undertaking this challenge. I also appreciate the role of students and parents in supporting these changes. Much more may need to be done in the coming years, as well as I would only request all of you to keep going along this direction with as much zeal and energy as you have shown in the past year. As we go further, we'll all see more impact of this change. Finally, let me get back to the task at hand today. Convocations are very special occasions. For graduating students and their parents, it's the end of a long journey. For teachers and the university, it is a moment of accomplishment. For the world at large, it is a moment of renewal and promise when a set of young people, equipped with their education, are about to contribute to the betterment of the society. Please join me in congratulating all the graduating students and those about to receive awards. I wish you the very best in all your future endeavors, and I'm sure that you will make us all proud. Thank you very much.